lovelies, welcome to my channel The Productive Girl. In today's video, let's unbox and review the Artloom 2022 planner. Let's get started. This is how the packaging came in. It's a normal cardboard packaging. First, let's have a look at the freebies. There are four freebies. First is 12 sets of sticker sheets with over 450 stickers. And let's have a look at these stickers first. Second is the canvas pouch which says Happy Mind, Happy Life, and their branding at the bottom. And this pouch helps us to keep and carry the planner safely, and it's perfectly fits the planner. The second last freebie is one chorus highlighter, and this is how the pigmentation of the highlighter looks like. It's bright and nice and it's good. And the final freebie is a bookmark with a quote which says, "You do not find the happy life, you make it." And that's all the freebies. Now let's come to the planner. The planner is wrapped in a paper which has the branding going on. And here is our beautiful planner. There are so many variants available. I went with Pretty in Pink. As the name suggests, it's a pretty pink color, and the cover says good things are coming, which is kind of embellished, and 2022 is mentioned below that. It's a hardbound planner and it has an elastic band closure to it. Now let's flip through the planner. First we have this annual planner belongs to, wherein we can write our name in the box. Next, when we turn the page, on the left, there is a letter from the Artloom team about the planner. There is a quote underneath which says, "An hour of planning can save you 10 hours of doing," by Dale Carnegie. And on the right, we have my biggest learning from 2021 and my greatest wish for 2022. It's like saying goodbye to 2021 and hello to 2022. It's a nice activity. Next, we have the yearly calendar for 2022. And on the right, we have holidays, the best days. They've mentioned all the holidays in the side. And when we turn upon, on the left, we have important dates, wherein we can write important days in each month, like birthdays, anniversary, etc. And on the right, we have a space to put our vision board. And next, when we turn, we have "Self-love is not selfish," a quote. And on the right, we have "Say it with stickers." This is about kind of a little fun activity, like you can answer for the question using the stickers. And when we turn, we have "Grateful for." It's a gratitude page and I really like it. So we can use these prompts below to identify what we are most grateful for in our life. And some of the prompts are family, friends, career, body, past, present ability to love off and things like that. She's 100% correct, and including this gratitude section with a prompts, it's nice. Then we have read this slowly page, wherein we have to read this thing slowly. Let's do that. Imagine your mind like a garden and your thoughts are the seeds. You get to choose what seeds you plant in it. You can plant seeds of positivity, love, and abundance. Or you can plant seeds of negativity, fear, and lack. You can spend time trying to take care of everyone else's garden, or you can work on making yours beautiful and attract other beautiful people to your garden. So it's really nice. They have conveyed the thought of our mind is a magnet through this like a story, and it's really nice. It can be easily understood, like how our thoughts making our mind. Then we have what if is equal to fear, even if is equal to faith. So this page is make your dreams happen. So we have 3-month goal, 6-month goal, 9-month goal, and 12-month goal. So we can have a lot of goals for each quarter. And next we have let's set goals and make plans. In this we have a lot of sections to make goals, like categories, which is personal, professional, health, financial, habits to adopt, habits to cut, new skills to learn, focus. So we can set goals in each categories. So if you're just unaware like how to set goals, you can think about these categories and come up with some ideas. Then we have recommendation side, which is movies to watch, restaurants to visit, books to read, and shopping. So it's like kind of recommendations or just documenting our own recommendations to ourselves. Then we have this year I want to do more of or less of. So they have given like 7 spaces to write, but it might be more beneficial if they have segregated the space for like this year I want to do more of, like a separate space, and this year I want to do less of, like a separate space, so that we can write what we have to do more and what we have to do less. But it would be nice if it organized like separately. Then here comes the monthly layouts, starting off with January. And the quote for the January is, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. It's on the left side, and on the right we have January, the month of dreams. And when we flip, first thing we can see is the trackers. So we have like 3 trackers. First is habit tracker, in which we can track 4 habits. And below that we have mood tracker, in which we can track our moods, emotions, and feelings every single day. And on the right we have budget tracker. At the bottom it is amount to pay, amount to receive. So this is a budget tracker. So there are 3 trackers available in this planner. Next we have the monthly overview, like calendar. And here we have all the holidays and special days color coded. I really like this, it's so colorful. And at the right we have monthly goals. Here we can write goals for the month with this kind of less, but there is enough space like lengthwise, so you can write about 3 to 5 goals in this section. Then when we flip, we also have goals for the month that's separated by weeks, like a weekly goals, week 1, week 2, week 3, and week 4. So it's kind of like a checkpoint or milestone for our one main goal. Okay, so for the one main goal, you can keep like a checkpoints or milestone mini goals for that in this space. So it's a nice idea. Below that we have main focus of the month. This space can be utilized like a theme of the month or like word of the month. Like this month I'm going to be focusing on self-care. Likewise, we can write the main focus. Then we have priorities and agendas, in which we can write our priorities, meetings. Then we have to-do list. It's kind of to-do list for achieving the goals or some things that we have to do within this month. Right, we have notes page, like one side full of notes, in which we can just brain dump or jot down our ideas or anything. Then we have the weekly / daily layout, in which we also have the water tracker going on, and it's dated completely and it's horizontal, so you can use it as a planner, like a writing to-do list, or you can also use it as a journal or diary. And at the end of the month we have end of the month reflection. It says describe your month in 3 words And then we have like a star ratings, like productive, unproductive, calm or stressed, like that. So you can just rate your month in stars. And then we have grateful for section, what worked and what did not, and most challenging part, happiest part of the month. As always, I really like reflections part, so including that is really nice. So this is how the monthly layout for January looks like, and it will be similar for every month. So let's just look at the cover page of every month. So this is a February, the month of love. For March, it is the month of expectations, and it has a quote, you do not find the happy life, you make it. For April, the month of blossoms. May, it's the month of imagination. June is the month of positivity. For July, we have a quote, what you think, you become. What you feel, you attract. What you imagine, you create. And it's the month of perfection. For August is the month of calm. And September, it's the month of change. For October, it's the month of kindness. For November, it's the month of gratefulness. For December, it's the month of celebration. And we have a quote, which is, you're worthy, you're capable, you're beautiful. Book the ticket, create the dream, celebrate yourself, rule your kingdom. So let's see what we have at the final ending of December. After the end of the month, we have one page, like a doodle here, which is dot grid. Like we can write bullet journal if we want, or we can just doodle, and that's it. With that, this planner came to the end. My review for this planner is, it's quite nice. It is simple. It has all the essential things that we need in a planner. Yeah, it is nice. This planner might be for you if you're someone who just want a simple yet colorful planner, which needs to have a habit tracker, mood tracker and budget tracker, and also daily planning pages and monthly reflections, then this planner is for you. This planner will not suitable for someone who wants a lot of details to the planner, who wants a lot of elements to the planner, like a lot of list. So that's my review for this planner. Let me know how many of you guys like this planner and your thoughts about it in the comments below. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I shall see you guys in my next video. Until then, be positive and spread positivity. Bye bye.